how's it going? So last... that's where I wish we could just leave it off at. But now we have to do these missions. Maybe I'll try this strategy. The sniper, the dual wield sniper strategy. Oh yeah, I forgot there aren't reds here.
destroy that fart that's glowing red.
The red part is probably a control unit. If it breaks, they'll lose control of the time machine and it will self-destruct.
Bottom.
This is all news to me. So if it weren't for that accident, we never could have taken down the ring.
There's a red thing on the bottom part of the ring. It's just like the control unit we destroyed.
So the ring has two control units. Move forward with the plan. Our target is the second control unit. Attack the glowing red part.
Calculating position based on diameter and angle. 500 meters to the new weak spot.
There we go.
Cannon has been deployed from the ring!
Our intel was correct, but we didn't foresee the timing.
Evolved enemy ship detected!
What the hell? It's way stronger than the ones.
Androids are coming down from the ring! Oh, dears! Android grenadiers!
They probably want to eliminate ground units to protect the ring.
So their strategy is to go straight to the explosives. They're sending in one weapon after another. All to defend the ring.
Yes, I was thinking thinking the same thing.
Take Sarge forever to get over here.
Thank you.
finally. It's still dead! The ring has lost balance! It's crashing!
Evacuate! Fast!
The ring's crashing! We won!
The time machine still seems to be functioning.
The ring somehow didn't crash. It's struggling to maintain balance.
So it can still fly.
The ring has stopped at the horizon. Multiple cannons have appeared.
Fucking Jesus. What the fuck is hitting me? Fucking good God. Are you fucking my asshole? Jesus Christ. Fucking piece of fucking shit. The fucking longest, shittiest fucking map. Fucking faggot shit. Kick this fucking ass.
There's no backup. We rely on the storm team.
Multiple drones around the ring! The ring seems to have activated!
God, these fucking last missions are fucking putrid dog shit. Drones
are coming out of the ring!
I'm sorry, they're spawning. Oh wait, that did happen. I forgot about this.
In order to maintain their forces, they have to be able to travel to exact points in time.
Traveling 100,000 years is sure to lead to errors in calculation. That's why they need to bring her.
Thank you.
control unit. If it breaks, they lose control of the time machine and it will self-destruct.
Fucking speed this shit up.
Cannon has been deployed from the ring.
Our intel was correct, but we didn't foresee the timing.
Thank you.
The situation is looking bad. We might need to prepare for the worst.
I never imagined it would turn out like this.
Made it in time! Now within range for submarine carrier support!
Epimetheus, coming to service. Enemy ship within firing range. Epimetheus, deploying weapons. Preparing to fire. Taking aim. Let's go. Pandora, taking aim. Siren, taking aim. Submarine carriers, launch triple strike. Epimetheus, now firing. Pandora, now firing. Siren, now firing.
Somehow didn't crash. It's struggling to maintain balance.
So it can still fly.
The ring has stopped at the horizon. Multiple cannons have appeared.
I didn't know it could deploy so many cannons at once. This is more than we can deal with. This thing's got incredible defenses.
Shit, is this fucking garbage? Jesus Christ. God, the fucking shittiest fucking level. the two shittiest turds, fucking Sandlot, shout out, at the very end of the game.
1 kilometer to the ring.
So we're the only ones that can ignore the insurgents.
We're the only ones who can keep up with the chief.
This five-year battle ends now.
We were gathered here today.
God.
This must be fate. There's no backup. We'll rely on the storm team.
Eliminate the drones!
Approaching the ring.
I love fucking taking 30 minutes just to get to that fucking part of the level.
The ring seems to have activated.
So that thing's a time machine.
Drones are coming out of the ring!
Fucking baggiest shit I've ever seen. Talking about me.
Control unit.
rotating. It seems to be rolling top over bottom.
This is all news to me. So if it weren't for that accident, we never could have taken down the ring.
Stop!
There's a red thing on the bottom part of the ring. It's just like the control unit we destroyed.
So the ring has two control units. Move forward with the plan. Our target is the second control unit. Attack the glowing red part.
Calculating position based on diameter and angle. 500 meters to the new weak spot. Cannon has been deployed from the ring.
Our intel was correct, but we didn't foresee the timing.
Evolved enemy ship detected! The enemy is activating their teleportation devices! Androids are coming down from the ring! Grenadiers!
Android Grenadiers, incoming!
They probably want to eliminate ground units to protect the ring.
So their strategy is to go straight to the explosives.
Play EDF 6 after this.
Made it in time! Now within range for submarine carrier support!
I mean, this game ends with the two biggest ships Sandlot's ever taken. Right on the consumer's face. So. They're pretty fucking bad. EDF-6 has the worst final missions that we've seen in a very long time. Like, these missions are fucking bad. These are fucking rancid pieces of shit. Not to mention all the fucking downtime in these missions. You gotta wait like 30 fucking minutes just for the next part of the level happens. So it makes it really fun to replay. There's ear rape happening soon. They needed that to be loud as fuck, way louder than anything else.
The ring's holding still in midair.
The ending of this game is such a downgrade from 5. Professor says something about it, so they have an explanation. I didn't care to listen, really.
We did it! The ring's done for!
You still haven't even played this?
It's still dead! The ring is left balance! It's crashing!
Evacuate! Fast!
The ring's crashing! We won!
The time machine still seems to be functioning.
The ring somehow didn't crash. It's struggling to maintain balance.
So it can still fly?
The ring has stopped at the horizon!
Weapons. Look how fucking tanky they fucking made all this shit.
Please aim for its green glowing point.
Come on, wait. observed. Oh yeah, it didn't actually get destroyed, there's the thing behind
it. Considering its central location, it must be an important device. And since it's currently activated, that means the time machine is in an unstable condition. The device is operating at full power, and thereby keeping the time machine functional. That's the most sensible explanation.
If that's true, the spinel is the ring's weak point.
So if we destroy the spinel, the ring will fall. Is that what you mean? Storm team, aim for the floating object at the center of the ring. That's its weak point.
Oh, my tank is getting the fast spot in this environment.
When the spinel opens, attack the inside.
Start doing that.
We shouldn't underestimate what the ring can do.
They've been keeping an arsenal of weapons in the future to protect their precious ring. But these are emergency measures. This isn't how the time machine is supposed to be used. They're desperate.
Continue to function once partially destroyed.
But then it will need time to reconfigure itself.
Commandos!
Drivers here, providing backup! our Commander-in-Chief. Commando team, joining forces.
I thought this guy was already dead. Wow, it's kind of close, a lot quicker. Yeah, now we have friends.
Enemies appearing from the ring!
The future primers are falling into chaos. They're sending any troops they can get their hands on.
Storm team, the enemy is heading down.
Something in the sky before anything actually was happening. Reverse or Goliath Slaughter. So, you know, everything that I could want except for the sniper rifles. It's a pain. Yeah, I mean, the slaughter looks really good, but other than the reload, that looks good. Yeah, the orchard does crazy damage. We got 4,000 health for this final mission.
That thing is officially our enemy. All units, initiate attack.
Eating its own tail.
It's too far. I can't shoot it.
Fucking hell. It's just visual noise right now.
There's something like a cannon on the side of the ship's bow.
Attack the cannon. Aim for the side of the ship's bow.
Ship for time travel afterwards, whether 10 or 100 years later.
So, it's from the post-reboot future.
It must be made with even more advanced technology than the ring. Truly fearsome.
So if we destroy this, won't they just send something else from even further in the future?
Yes, in another 10 or 100 years. The primers will make a new weapon and send it too. They won't stop until they win.
What the hell?
We're not just fighting the primers from a certain era. We're fighting all primers that ever existed.
All primers from every period in time. There's no way we can win. They'll try again no matter how many times they lose.
I had this thing
that you're supposed to do.
The mouth of a dragon. It is probably tower to protect the opening to find the cabin. There should be an area with weak protection around the firing device.
In other words, the bowser is the weak point.
The ship's head is the weak point. Aim for inside of the mouth.
Nobody can shoot that. Oh, What am I seeing?
Their ship's changing!
What happened?
There he is, our old friend.
No way! What the hell is that?
It's like an alien.
Don't tell me it's there.
What?
A god.
Oh, fuck's sake.
A golden ship. I've heard a legend like that. That is a god.
Don't be stupid.
There was wreckage from an alien spacecraft discovered in the mountains of India from thousands of years ago.
That's why the EDF was created.
The Primers have been coming to Earth for a very, very long time. Humanity believed them to be gods and created legends about them. We knew the Primer civilization had lasted for thousands of years. But now it hits home. They really traveled across time to get here. In other words, gods are still alive today. For the Primer species, it's an incredible entity. Irreplaceable.
Whatever this entity is, we have to fight it if we want to survive.
Plays with the light and dances in the sky, just like the legends say.
These guys aren't even primers. How come they can get spawned
to summon? Was sent to Mars. We will detonate it.
There's no point in playing this fucking game. Awesome. I love playing the longest fucking mission on the planet and then having it crash because the port fucking sucks dog shit. Thank you. It's awesome. Do I even want to boot it back up? piss.
Yeah, I'm driving down the road in the truck. Yeah, I'm driving down the road in the truck. I'm gonna flip them off. There comes a toll booth. Let me move my hands so I can roll down my window. Here's $5. Blah 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 blah. Here's $50. Shut up. Blah 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 blah. Well, fuck your eyes. Bam with the bam down 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 in the face. Dun 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 dun. Can't still believe I'm on this road, but here in a truck and I'm flipping it off again. Down down down. Yeah, it's another toll booth. Damn it. Damn 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 damn. Here's $5. I don't take prize from your time with $50. Your ass is so screwed. Well, fuck you, dude. I'm calling up right now. Well, fuck your face. Yeah, I'm driving down the road in the truck. I'm gonna flip them off. There comes a toll booth. Let me move my hands so I can roll down my window.
Try this one more time. How long has this game been out by now?
That thing is officially our enemy. All units, initiate attack.
It must be from the future too.
Really? That's not close enough to hit it.
We think that's the primest ship for time travel.
They have this.
On the middle of the ship, teams in front of the ship's bow should either retreat or hide.
I can't shoot far enough!
It's over 1 kilometer. A giant ship beyond anything seen so far. A very long-range weapon will be necessary to shoot it from the ground.
It moves much faster than its appearance would suggest. It might be hard to land attacks from the ground.
It's too far for my attacks to reach! It's too far! I can't shoot it!
There's something where they had it on the side of the ship's bow.
Zexar guns, because it didn't change. It didn't change because it didn't keep my... Oh my god, this game fucking blows my fucking car. Disgusting piece of shit game.
Omega. You can't be serious.
three cannons. There's spawners that haven't turned on yet. Yeah. Even though it goes red, it doesn't have to be. There's like enemies under the ground.
Ignition in 3, 2, 1. Kaboom.
Kaboom.
Pollutants are spreading.
The future has changed. The primer civilization no longer exists.
But our enemies, they're still here.
It's very strange. Primers are erased from history. They should be extinct.
What the?
Extinct. They've grown even stronger.
Yeah. Fucking what the fuck was that shit?
Exist, the war wouldn't have happened and humanity wouldn't have nuked Mars. Then the Primers would have ended up being born on Mars and attacking humanity. A paradox.
This distortion must be corrected. Time must choose a side. Humanity or the Primers.
Wow. Wow. What the fuck? Jesus, did they ever fucking stop coming after us? This fucking blows dick.
To return to. Get rid of them, then everything will be finished.
Okay, yes, way less so. gets all the grace. Damn it. No, what the fuck? He doesn't die.
This is Carrier, arrived on scene. I confirm any coordinates.
Of course he knows how to do that. Get in the fucking thing.
Exactly.
Ever since the primers interfered with human history, the time paradox has been intensifying. At that point, you were chosen as the person who would take on the burden of representing humanity. You are the one.
The chosen one.
The fuck am I looking at?
The representative of humanity across time.
Can show up, don't even bother fucking with it. You know, the Endless doesn't drop nearly as much in this game as he does in the last game.
History has been corrected. Will stabilize. Time chose humanity. The future has been settled. The primers are no more. How will humanity walk forth? Now that we know the future, it's up to us to decide. You changed everything. I give you my deepest gratitude.
Me too. Thank you.
Same for me. I really appreciate it.
I really appreciate it.
Thank you so, so much. I love you.
Awesome. That's a good way to end right there. I thought it was going to be stuck for good. We did it. At last, the battle is over. The planet is awash in mourning. Humanity has lost 30% of its total population. The primers brought their science and technology. With their advanced knowledge, the human race is sure to make leaps and bounds. The primers are gone, and no more will come from Mars. Knowing the future, humanity is ready to take the next step. Yeah, that last timeline, the primers really did suck, huh? Only 30% of humanity died. Still said there is hope. Chaos will come to an end, evil will not spread, and violence will not prevail. New justice shall be hailed, and order shall be returned to the people. None of that was wrong. That's exactly what happened. We knew this would happen all along. Why? Because you are here. Protector of people. Defender of peace. The champion of this planet. You are. EDF. Desolate World Captain B was played by Crash Lovedog. Alright, now that the missions are done, I still don't like those missions, but I don't hate them as much as I did. But I'm still not a fan. But they're not as bad as I was saying. Still, the ring, because it's just, the ring is the mothership, and the endless is the endless. The endless now in snake form. So it's still the exact same, like, you know, setup as it is in EDF5. But in EDF5, the Endless is an actual, like, boss enemy. And not just a stupid flying gimmick. He's actually an enemy that takes... just a normal enemy that takes space in the map itself. And not some dumb shit that's flying out of bounds all the time. Just spends most of its time out of bounds than it does in bounds. Got my achievement. UMFF NP4. Yeah, it doesn't. They're not even gonna give me the fucking. I want upgrades for the, you know, for the Fang and the Lysander. Alright, we did it. It's all done. We have 100%ed Ranger. God, see, that was 100%ing it with one class. And that took forever. Alright, I guess I will just do, like, the first few DLC 1 missions, then. I'm not gonna play, like, a huge chunk of DLC 1 right now, but I'll do some of the early stuff.